When you look at the population map of the states of the United States, you see strange demographic divisions. For example, consider Massachusetts with 7 million inhabitants, which is twice the population of the three northern states. Delving deeper, we ask why only 2% of the US population lives in this vast area, and why the population is so different between Arizona and New Mexico. Also, if you look carefully at California, you will notice that this state, with its population of 40 million people, exceeds the combined population of 10 states in the western half of this country. But the most interesting relation in the population distribution is that of the 9 most populous states, whose combined population is equal to or slightly larger than the other 41 states, thus raising a fundamental question of what makes up half of the United States population only concentrated in 9 states. Welcome to another video from Geography Tour channel. As shown in the picture, 9 populous states are scattered in different regions of the country, and it is interesting to note that most of these states are located in the eastern belt of the United States, which have formed states with a small area and a large population. Also, looking into history, we find that the formation of the western states occurred after the formation of the United States, which was caused by the search for new resources through westward expansion. Which makes us wonder why people throughout history have left the western states and moved to the most populous state, California. Therefore, in order to better understand these strange population divisions, we must examine each of the 9 states separately, explore the reason why their population is more than the other states. First, we go to the east of the United States, which is in the list of 9 most populous states. The 5 states of New York, Pennsylvania, Ohio, Illinois, and North Carolina, which shows that the majority of the population of the United States lives not only in these 5 states, but also in the east of the country. According to statistics, 80% of the population of the United States is located in the eastern belt. As I said, the initial settlement in America began in the eastern states, which can be referred to the discovery of the Spaniards in 1492, which, after a period of exploration with the support of the great European countries, the first successful English settlement in 1607 was created in this area. In fact, the Spanish explorers were the first Europeans to reach the present-day United States after the Scandinavians, and after Christopher Columbus' explorations began in 1492, they established a territory in the Caribbean Sea, including present-day lands such as Puerto Rico. Then, in 1513, Juan Ponce de Leon moved to Florida, which was the first step of the Spanish to the mainland. And then, the Spanish explorers quickly reached the Alapache Mountains, the Mississippi River, and the Plains, which caused many parts of the eastern United States to fall into the hands of the Spanish Kingdom until 1539, and thus the life of European immigrants began in this continent. So the east of the United States started earlier than the west because European powers had a great incentive to establish colonies, and even the land was easily arable, and there were other advantages. Also, when the United States became a country in the 1770s, with 13 states on the east coast, people were building cities and towns for several hundred years, while the western United States did not see many immigrants, and there were few reasons to migrate to the west. Therefore, the east of the country is older than the west, which has caused the population growth through birth to have a significant progress compared to the west. And in addition, today there are many reasons why people do not migrate to the western parts, which is one of the most important that can be referred to the weather. Because there are many freshwater rivers and lakes on the eastern coast of the United States, and because of the abundant rainfall, many people have preferred these areas to live. Now we continue to the southeast coast, which is in the list of 9 most populous states. 2 states, Florida and Georgia, which have interesting reasons for people to migrate to these 2 states. Notably, Florida, which was the fastest growing state last year for the first time since 1957, actually surpassed 22 million in population, fueled by the 3.1 million added in the previous decade. To put that 3.1 million in perspective, if Florida were its own state, it would be the 33rd most populous state on its own, slightly larger than Arkansas and slightly smaller than Nevada. Therefore, one of the most important reasons for people to migrate to Florida is the famous beaches of this state, which have created a paradise for retirees and young people. In addition, the strong labor market and the fact that, unlike most US states, Florida does not have a state income tax has been influential in population growth, which caused Florida to record the fastest housing price growth in recent years. In fact, the average price of a house in Florida increased by 14% last year, which is very high compared to the national average of 8.7%, and this made life expensive in this state. Now we come to the two important states of the country that constitute the most populated states. In fact, Texas and Florida are located in the southern and western belt of the United States, in contrast to the huge population of the East Coast, which by passing through the central belt is devoid of population. We reach two states. As you know, the population of California is 39 million people and the population of Texas is 30 million people. For a total of 69 million people, that alone constitute 20% of the population of the United States, while covering only 11% of the area. So you ask yourself, what is the main reason for the significant population growth in these two states that attracted so many immigrants? We begin first with Texas, where there were mass immigrants to Texas during the 19th century, one of the largest influxes occurring between 1821 and 1836, when an estimated 38,000 settlers traveled from the United States into the territory in response to promises of 4,000 acres of land per family. Additionally, in the three decades before the American Civil War, shiploads of German, Polish, Czech, Swedish, Norwegian, and Irish immigrants made their way to Texas from the East Coast, causing a large population growth through European immigrants. In fact, nearly two-fifths of the people of Texas are Hispanic, who immigrated to the state for several reasons. And also, in the years after the Civil War, many families moved from the devastated farms of the South to the farms of Texas. Today, the population of Texas continues to grow, having recently passed the 30 million mark, and from 2000 to 2022, they still added 9 million people, more than any other state by nearly 3 million more than Florida. It has seen an increase in population. Unlike Florida, where growth was driven primarily by internal migration, Texas experienced modest increases in all components of population change, with about half of Texas' population growth since 2000. Resulting from natural increases in births rather than deaths. There was another 29% of the net income of internal migration and 22% of the net income of international migration. Now, if you pass Texas, you will reach the most populous state, California, which is interesting to know that one out of every eight residents in the United States lives in this state, at the beginning of which people migrated from the east to the west with numerous gold discoveries, which actually crossed the western states in 1848 for the gold rush and reached California, as well as later immigrants from the eastern United States. They came to this state to find their jobs and escape from the cold winters in the east. So today the state has a very strong economy that has created immigration, because California is the fifth most powerful economy in the world and even has the potential to be recognized as an independent country. In fact, with a strong economy comes economic opportunities that create many jobs, and people come to California for jobs, as has a recent wave of immigrants from Mexico and Central America. In the end, in contrast to these nine states, there are also sparsely populated states, the most of which can be mentioned in the central belt of the United States, which have seen a very small population due to the lack of water and dryness. Therefore, these demographic divisions have caused the population of only 9 states to be equal to the population of 41 other states. Thanks for being with me until the end of the video, and see you in another video.